World War I started on July 28, 1914, and the battle was fought on land, in the air, and on the seas. The United States entered the war in April 1917. 10 days later, the Emergency Fleet Corporation was established to acquire, maintain, and operate merchant ships. The manufacturing of airplanes, tanks, and ships put tremendous strain on the financial, labor, and raw materials of this country, especially steel. To mitigate the steel shortage, some ships were made from alternate materials such as wood and ferroconcrete, the FE being steel rebar reinforcement of a concrete shell. A bid went out for the construction of 5 concrete water tenders, 100 feet in length, capable of holding 52,000 gallons of water. The Great Northern Concrete Shipbuilding Company had the winning bid. The factory was in Vancouver, Washington, at the bottom of Columbia Way. The boats were powered by twin 120 horsepower Frisco Standard distillate engines. Distillate is an unfiltered form of kerosene. If you're guessing Frisco referred to San Francisco, you'd be correct. But after merger, the production was moved across the bay to Oakland. By January 1919, the first water tender was ready to be launched. There was some excitement about the anticipated arrivals. Also controversy, as cement ships gained the nickname stone ships. I'd imagine the locals were placing bets on if they would float. Here we see one of the completed ships. This photo taken sometime in 1919. The plan was for all 5 water tenders to be towed up the Columbia River to Astoria, Oregon. Then 4 of the ships would continue down the west coast to be delivered to various locations. The journey would certainly take more than 3 hours, but in the end, 3 of the water tenders were lost. The story of that journey is too long for this video, but it is a great read. Head on over to the Greed Fleet, which was a source for much of this video. The surviving 2 water tenders were sold off in 1921 to this woman. Well, maybe not directly. This is Thea Foss, who would start the company that would become the West Coast's largest maritime towing company. She started it with $5. Today, they are the company you call when you need a big job done. By the 1920s, Foss had operations in several locations, this one being in Port Angeles, Washington. While the Foss tugs are named after family members, the barges are simply numbered. I can't find any pictures of the concrete ships as Foss vessels. This isn't my first video about a Foss barge. Check out my video on the USS Overton County. If you look close, you can see the Fossil 1 has been painted over. Here's a comparison of the original drawings with the present-day Captain Barker. I'll call that a match. The Captain Barker is located near other notable ships, but is simply referred to as the Cement Hulk. The Captain Barker is located near the city of Dupont and has been at this location since 1968. While it is listed as a shipwreck, it was intentionally scuttled. Park at City Hall and take about an hour walk to the ship. Check tide tables first, as you should be able to walk to the boat during a minus tide. The Captain Boots is located north of the city of Everett, Washington. It's part of a long line of wooden ships that were used to form a breakwater around 1960. History can be fuzzy, as I've heard these wooden ships called sailing schooners, World War II barrack ships, and cargo barges. Would you like to know more about concrete ships? Please let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe.